Chapter 10 Description of Forms of Lord Narasimha. I took leave from Tirumala Das and continued my journey towards Kuruvapuram. My hairs were raising end on as I think of Shri Pada's Leelas in my mind. On my way, I saw an Ashwatha tree at a distance. That was midday. I was very hungry. I thought of asking for food if there was any Brahmin Agraharam nearby and take rest under the Ashwatha tree. I could barely see someone taking rest under the tree. When I went a little nearer, I saw that person having Yagnopavitam, the sacred thread. I came near the Ashwatha tree. That new person respectfully welcomed me and asked me to sit. From his eyes, grace was flowing. There was a jangidi, a basket, in front of him. There was no food material in that. Only one copper vessel was there. He was often repeating Shripada Shrivallabha's name. I asked him curiously, "Sir, are you a devotee of Shripada's divine Sri Charanas? Did you see that great sacred person?" He said, "Sir, I was born in a good Vaishya family. My name is Subbaya Shreshti. I lost my parents in my childhood. There was plenty of wealth in our house. I used to go to distant places and do buying and selling of many different kinds. I often would go to Kanchipuram. There, I got in touch with a prostitute by name Chintamani. I spent a lot of money carelessly. One Brahmin by name Bilvamangala also used to come to Kanchipuram for business purpose from Palakkadu of Malayaladesham. He would sell scents to Arabic people and take diamonds and horses from them. Sometimes we would do business together. Kings used to buy good horses from us. Because of ill fate, both of us fell from righteous path because of the association with the prostitute. The business we were doing with Arabic people went on enthusiastically for some time. Later, they took great amount of money from us and gave poor quality horses. We lost heavily in business. We lost our property also. My wife died of mental disease. I had a son who was mentally retarded. He also died early. My dear, our village is Shripitikapuram, which has the Padagaya Tirtham, which can be called greatest among the Tirthas. Because of ignorance, I used to blame gods and Brahmins. I was very tough in recovering dues. Once, many relatives came from Ainavilli village to the house of Shripada's father, Appala Raja Sharma. He did not have enough money to arrange food for all of them. If he went to Venkatappaya Shreshti for food materials, he would not take money from Appala Raja Sharma as he was their Purohit. Then it would become a donation. But Appala Raja Sharma would not accept any donation. In unavoidable circumstances, he took the material costing one varaha from my shop. After the relatives went, I pestered Raja Sharma to clear my dues. Raja Sharma replied that he had no money in his hands and he would repay whenever he got the money. I was an expert in collecting compound interest. Time was running. I calculated interest on interest and demanded that he would have to give me 10 varahas. Appala Raja Sharma would have to sell his house to pay me that much money. According to the rates prevailing in those days, it would be sufficient to take the possession of that house and give back one or two varahas to him. I would tell this in front of many people. My desire was to make Raja Sharma a homeless person. Noticing my bad thought, Venkatappaya Shreshti said, "Oh cruel fellow, you are talking as you like, blinded by your wealth. If you insult our Purohit, it is like insulting us. If you do not change your ways, you will be losing severely. You will go to Rauravanarakas if you torture Raja Sharma, who is more sacred than Agnihotram." Once, Shripada was at the house of Venkatappaya Shreshti. I sarcastically told Shreshti, "If Raja Sharma cannot repay my debt, he should send any of his sons to serve in my shop. One son is a blind fellow and the other son is a lame fellow. The third one, Shripada, is mere 3-year-old boy. How will my debt be cleared?" Venkatappaya Shreshti was hurt badly. Tears started flowing from his eyes. Shripada wiped those tears with his divine hands and said, Tata, why do you fear when I am here? I was the one who killed Hiranyaksha and Hiranyakashyapa. It is not difficult for me to clear the Subbaya's debt. Shripada looked at me and said, I will clear your debt. Let us go. I will work in your shop and clear your debt. But after the debt is cleared, Lakshmi will not stay in your house. Think about it. Blinded by ego and cruelty, I agreed. Venkatappaya Shreshti lifted Shripada onto his shoulders, came to my house and said, I will work in your shop in place of Shripada. Is it agreeable to you? I said yes. Meanwhile, a Jatadhari, having long matted hair sannyasi, came to me and asked where the shop of Subbaya Shreshti was. I said, I am Subbaya Shreshti. This is my shop. He said, Sir, I need a copper vessel urgently. Let the rate be high. Please give me the vessel immediately. I will take it and go away. I was having 32 copper vessels. But I said, I had only one copper vessel with me, and if he gave me 10 varahas, I would give it. He immediately agreed. But he put a condition that Shripada sitting in Venkatappaya Shreshti's lap should give that copper vessel to him with his own hands. Shripada agreed. The Jatadhari took the copper vessel from Shripada's hands. Shripada was laughing. Jatadhari also started laughing. Shripada told Jatadhari, Your wish is fulfilled. Lakshmi will reside stably in your house. You end your sannyasa diksha and go to your house. Your wife and children are waiting for you. Jatadhari went quite happily. I had a desire to insult Venkatappaya Shreshti and Appala Raja Sharma. That desire was fulfilled now. With pride I said, Today I got good amount of money by selling this copper vessel. I conclude that Appala Raja Sharma's debt of 10 varahas has been cleared. From this moment, Shripada is released. But Venkatappaya Shreshti told me to say this under oath in the name of Gayatri. Being dull-headed, I said so. My dear Shankar Bhatt, if someone received even a small piece of copper as graceful prasad from Avadhutas or Siddha Purushas, he will get plenty of wealth. So the Jatadhari, who took the copper vessel from Sri Vallabha himself, the embodiment of Sri Datta, was highly fortunate. I was extremely unlucky. The Lakshmi Amsha embedded in my body, mind and Atma started waning. Shripada's leelas are unpredictable and cannot be comprehended. The words spoken in front of him become true. I lied that I had only one copper vessel when in fact I had 32 of them. Shripada made my lie true. After Venkatappaya Shreshti and Shripada left the shop, I found that there was only one copper vessel instead of 31. I did false calculations and demanded 10 varahas from Appala Raja Sharma. Accordingly, he saw that I got 10 varahas. Through this leela, Shripada removed certain misunderstandings of Appala Raja Sharma. The times before sunrise and before sunset are very sacred. It gives special good results if one does Agnihotra in the morning sandhya or dawn and sayam sandhya, dusk. During dawn, all the powers of sun will be ready to explode. During dusk, all the powers of sun will retreat into him. I said, Sir, I heard that the power of merit is reduced by taking donation, but I am hearing from you that one gets sin by not taking donation. I did not understand this. You are telling that Shripada is an avatar of Dattatreya. People say he is an avatar of Narasimha and Shiva in different ways. I also do not understand how Anasuya Tattvam remain merged in Shiva. Please explain clearly. Subbaya Shreshti said, Sir, you are hungry. Sri Vallabha tells his devotees to give food and water to those who come to their house without considering their caste and creed. You take food first. There is a water tank nearby. You take bath and come. Meanwhile, I will go and get 2 plantain leaves from that nearby plantain grove. We have Birakaya, rich god dal, along with rice. That will be very tasty like Amrit. I was surprised. In that Jangidi, There was only one copper vessel and nothing else. There were no groceries, fruits or tubers. Moreover, he was telling that Beerakaya dal was there to be taken with rice. Whatever it was, I thought of going to have bath first. Subbaya Shreshti went towards plantain trees. I went to water tank, had bath and came back fresh. Subbaya Shreshti brought two plantain leaves. He got few palm leaves from nearby palm trees and made them into small containers. I was looking at this strangely. He closed his eyes and did dhyana for a moment. Then he took the copper vessel and poured water into those two palm leaf containers. It was a wonder to see water coming from that empty copper vessel. After that, from the same copper vessel, he served Beerakaya dal on the plantain leaf. Later, he served rice. We both took that food, which was in plenty and was also very tasty as prasad. After we finished our meals, that copper vessel remained empty as usual. The effect of Shiva worship at Shani Pradosha, evening Sandhya on Saturdays. Shanishwara, Saturn is one who makes people do karmas. There are two shadow planets, Rahuvu and Ketuvu. Rahuvu gives effect similar to Shanishwara. Ketuvu will give effect similar to Angaraka or Kuja. Shanishwara, who is responsible for doing karmas, is the son of Sun, who is the witness of all karmas. So, the evening Sandhya, dusk on Saturday, is very powerful. The powerful Thithis of Rahu planet are Chaturthi, 4th day, and Trayodashi, 13th day. The effect of great sins committed in previous births will be completely annihilated for people who worship Shiva in the evening Sandhya on Shani Trayodashi day. Sripada was born in Chitta star, which is the star of Angaraka, Kuja. So, if people worship Sripada in Chitta star, all the ill effects that occur due to all planets will abate. Angaraka planet is responsible for wars, troubles, untimely deaths due to Shastras, weapons, and Astras, weapons powered by mantras, and leading life with debts and mundane problems. Runa is sin. Aruna is not having sin. Sripada will shine with Aruna, red color, on Chitta star day and on Tuesdays. He will be in the form of Arunachaleshwara in those days. Venkatappaya Shreshti, Narasimha Varma and Bapanarya used to participate in Shiva worship on Shani Pradosha. On that day, Appala Raja Sharma also would observe strict austerities and Akhanda Lakshmi Saubhagyavati, Sumati Maharani would be in dhyana on Anasuya Mahatattvam merged in Shiva Swarupam. As an effect of that tapas, Sripada's manifestation occurred. So, Sripada indicated to his father silently that taking money from Venkatappaya Shreshti, Narasimha Varma or Bapanarya would not be counted as dhanam, donation, and if money was not accepted from them, it would be counted as a great sin. Shankar Bhatt, Sripada has all forms of gods in him. He is the Mahatattva, which is beyond all gods. People who can get his darshan, sparshan or touch and sambhashan, talk, are really blessed. Subbaya Shreshti continued to tell. The story of Sripada freeing his father from debt in this way spread like a wildfire throughout Pitikapuram. Sripada was a 3-year-old boy. Tears flowed from the eyes of Appala Raja Sharma continuously. Sumati Maharani held her dear son to her heart and remained in ecstasy for a long time. Venkatappaya Shreshti, Narasimha Varma and Bapanarya came to Raja Sharma's house. Sripada said that it was the duty of son to liberate his father from debt. I was also invited to come to Raja Sharma's house. In the presence of all elders assembled there, I declared that Raja Sharma's debt was cleared. Raja Sharma did not agree to that. He questioned how his debt was said to have been cleared when some Jatadhari came and brought a copper vessel. Then there occurred an interesting discussion in this way. Bapanarya questioned Sripada, "Do you know who that Jatadhari was?" Sripada said, "Not only that Jatadhari, I know about all Jatadharis." The real form of Sripada, Bapannaria, you are a boy of 3 years. You are talking words beyond the comprehension of your age. Are you omniscient to know about everything? Shripada, you are all thinking that my age is 3 years. But I am not thinking so. My age is many lakhs of years. I was there before this creation. I will be there after Pralaya. I will be there during the process of creation also. If I am not there, Srishti, creation, Sthiti, protection and Laya, annihilation cannot take place. I will be looking at all these as a witness. Bapannaria, Shripada, if a small boy thinks that he is in Chandramandalam, this is not to be taken as he is in Chandramandalam physically. There must be a direct experience. Omniscience, omnipotence and omnipresence are the qualities of only the Jagat Prabhu, Lord of Universe. Shripada, I am the Adi Tattva, Supreme Brahman, present always and everywhere. Depending on the need, I express myself revealing that I am there. Simply because I have not expressed myself, it should not be taken that I am not there. I am present established in the Annamaya, Pranamaya, Manomaya, Vijnanamaya and Anandamaya koshas, layers of jivas. Because of my presence only, they are doing their respective functions. If I give you the experience that I am there, you will be able to appreciate that I am there. That does not mean that I am not there. I am always there everywhere. All forms of knowledge are at my feet. This creation happened on my will only. Where is the question of surprise if I say that I am omnipotent? Appala Raja Sharma, my dear, you have been problematic to us from the beginning. You are repeatedly telling that you are Datta Prabhu. You are also repeatedly telling that you will come as Drasimha Saraswati in another avatar. People are like crows. They are telling that this is all drama, falsehood and foolishness due to mental imbalance and in many different ways. We are Brahmins. It is good to do the dharma karmas allotted to us. It will be construed as egoistic if we say that we are born with godly powers and avatara purushas. Shripada, Father, I do not deny what you say. We have to tell the truth. I am amused when the matter of milk debt was raised. When Panchabhuthas were made to testify, will it not be a lie? If I say I am not Datta Prabhu, seeing the sun in the sky, if we say he is not the sun, he still remains sun only. Truth is not affected by place and time. Our Pitikapuram Brahmanyam think that they are bearers of body and human beings and are experiencing human tattvam. Similarly, I am reminding you again and again that I am Datta, having omniscience, omnipotence and omnipresence. Yugas may pass. Many worlds may pass through the stages of creation, existence and annihilation. But I, being Datta, remain Datta only. Bapannaria, Shripada, after Jatadhari left, there remained only one copper vessel with Subbaya Shreshti instead of 31. Did you do any trick and made them disappear? Shripada, everything happens due to some reason as the effect of time and actions. No action happens without a cause. This is the rule in nature, Prakriti, which cannot be transgressed. This Subbaya Shreshti in previous birth was a priest in a Datta temple in a forest. In forest areas, very few people come for Datta Darshan. He was mad with lust for women. Being a womanizer, he decided to sell that big Datta idol made of copper. The money he got by selling was given to his mistress. He told people that thieves stole the idol. The person who came as Jatadhari was a goldsmith who was entangled in worldly bonds. In his previous birth, also as a goldsmith, he melted that Datta idol for the sake of money. As a result, he is now born as a poor man. Subbaya Shreshti is born in a wealthy house because he served Datta as a pujari for many years. The Datta idol melted by these two people was made into 32 copper vessels and was sold. In goldsmith's house, they used to worship Narasimhadeva. The goldsmith made these copper vessels in front of the idol of Narasimhadeva So by the will of God, the Amshas of the 32 avatars of Narasimha Deva entered into those 32 copper vessels. In this birth, the goldsmith who had the knowledge of his previous birth served me with stable devotion. He prayed wholeheartedly to remove his poverty. I gave darshan to him in his dream and told him to come to Pitikapuram and take the copper vessel from me. In return, I told him to give 10 varahas to Shreshti and make me born free. He did similarly and got blessed. I graced him such a way that his financial problems were solved in an unexpected way. He was moving in the form of a Jatadhari to escape from the people who gave him loans. Thus, I know everything about that Jatadhari. This Subbaya Shreshti tried to extract 10 varahas from our family unjustly. I ensured that he got 10 varahas, but in return, I destroyed his merit of previous births. O Subbaya Shreshti, I know the romance and improper actions you did with Chintamani. Your story will remain ridiculous in history. You will live by selling eatables required for small children like me, carrying a jangdi basket. My parents made food for their relatives with the money taken from you. I know the calculation more than you. Your money was sufficient to cook rice, dal and beerakaya only. Other things were bought by my father's earnings. When you reach the pitiable state, when you cannot even get food, you will get water, rice, dal and beerakaya only from the copper vessel you have. You will get only that much to eat yourself and serve anyone present with you. Thus he spoke sharply. Shripada's face was fiery with divine luster. His eyes were like balls of fire. Again he said, O Subbaya Shreshti, a buffalo will come to the southern entrance of your house tonight. It is an indication from Yamadharma Raja that your death is nearing. But I am showing mercy on you. You cook rice, dal and beerakaya with your own hands and feed that buffalo. That is the only wish that buffalo has. After eating, it will die instead of you. From that moment, you will get message after message that you are becoming poorer and poorer. You take the jangdi and do what I said. Later, when you cannot even get food, the copper vessel will favor you as I said. Thus he said sharply. Venkatappaya Shreshti was frightened seeing an angry Shripada. Shripada said, Tata, are you afraid? I am indeed Narasimha Murthy. There should not be any doubt. I am Shripada Shrivallabha. You are afraid that I will curse the Vaishya caste. You are afraid that I will curse that Vaishyas will become poor, just as Vasavi Mata gave the curse that Vaishyas would have less beauty. Don't be afraid. God will not differentiate castes and creeds. Similarly, devotee also will not have caste or creed. My attachment with Arya Vaishyas is very ancient. Bapanarya was Labhada Maharshi in previous Yuga. I am giving you boon. Though the Gotra, lineage of Labhada Maharshi has become extant, Bapanarya's descendants will remain till the end of Kali Yuga. The jangdi I am giving you is different. It contains Datta Mithai, sweet preparation in plenty. It will not exhaust even if any amount is eaten away. All the qualities of the 32 avatars of Drisima are in me. Mine is 33rd avatar. So when the 33rd generation is running in your descendants, when Bapanarya's 33rd generation is running and Vatsavayi Narasimha Varma's 33rd generation is running, my Shri Padukas will be installed exactly at the place of my birth. This is my assurance to Vatsavayi family, Malladi family and Venkatappaya family. If anyone in the descendants of your families worship me in any way, out of 9 types of bhaktis, the Dattas dogs will be guarding him incognito. Vedas, Puranas and Upanishads will always protect them in the form of unseen dogs. My Padukas will not be installed in Pitikapuram in any other way than what I have said today. I am bound by my promise always. Our house changes into many hands and reach your descendants. It will be called Datta Nilayam. In front of this house, I came in the form of Avadhuta, asked Bhavati Bhiksham Dehi and gave Darshan to Sumati Mata. My brother, in his next Janma, with the name Sridhara, will become famous as partial Datta manifestation. He will come on 6-7-1963 Saturday, 4-8-1971 Wednesday and 11-9-1970 Friday, three times to the same place in the form of a dog, in settled form, and will eat Bhiksha Annam. After some time, one person of 33rd generation in Bapanarya's family will take food in your descendant's house in Datta Nilayam. This is my rule. My resolve is strong in fulfilling my promise. Venkatappaya Shreshti held Sripada to his heart. Pleasure tears were flowing from his eyes. No word could come out of Bapanarya's mouth. Sumati Mata was in a dilemma whether it was a dream or Vishnu Maya. Appala Raju Sharma's mind became dumb. Sripada's both elder brothers were looking at Sripada with fear. They were wondering whether he was their younger brother or Datta Prabhu. My foolishness and sarcastic attitude had no limits. So I said, Sripada, when the Shakti of race took human form, they were present as wives in Krishna avatar. Was it not womanizing? It is called Leela in the case of avatars, but in our case, it is called womanizing. Why is this discrimination? Sripada said, Shri Krishna had 8 wives and 16,000 gopikas. Still, he was a true brahmachari. He was not a womanizer as you think. It was not a bodily relation at all. They were wives as related to Atma. The Atma which is born, supported, is Bharya, wife. The Atma which bears it is called Bharta, husband. There is nothing else. When Devendra was cursed to be born as man, Sachidevi was born as Draupadi. Devendra took 5 forms and was born as 5 Pandavas. Though Draupadi had 5 husbands, she had bed pleasure with only Arjuna. Dharma is different and settled dharma is different. Kunti Mata never took back her word. Draupadi chose only Arjuna as husband. The Matsya Yantra, the fish machine, was head by Arjuna only. Dharma Patni, wife, has 6 qualities. In appearance, she should be like Lakshmi. Draupadi had plenty of grace in her. She should be like Bhudevi, earth, in forgiveness and patience. Sahadeva knew the events that were going to happen in future. He knew that war would happen between Kauravas and Pandavas. But before that happened, many things were to happen. Some of them were distress-causing events. When he thought of them, he would be restless. So, while dealing with Sahadeva, Draupadi conducted herself with extreme patience. Bhima was a heavy eater. Because of more eating, he used to be extremely lazy. So while dealing with Bhima, she behaved like a servant. Dharmaraja was the eldest in Pandavas. His mind was perturbed by many problems related to politics. So, Draupadi used to give good advice to Dharmaraja like a minister. Nakula was a skillful warrior who could wield his sword swiftly between 2 drops of rainwater without the sword getting wet. While practicing such sharp war skills, he would be having extreme hunger. So Draupadi used to prepare his food with good taste according to his mind's satisfaction, which was more useful for his skillful practices. She used to behave with Nakula like a mother who would understand the needs of her child and feed him without asking. She used to please Arjuna with her cleverness in giving bed pleasure like Rambha. Though she was having 5 husbands, she gave bed pleasure only to Arjuna without deviating from Dharma. Subhaya Shreshti, Chintamani, whom you took as your mistress, did not give bed pleasure only to you. Bilva Mangala and many others experienced her body. When you go to have darshan of Panakala Swami in Mangalagiri in Guntur Mandalam, Chintamani and Bilva Mangala will meet you there in accordance with the effect of time, action and cause. You will bring them to Petikapuram. I will teach you Dharma. Narasimha Varma took Sripada into his lap. Shripada told Varma, "Tata, tomorrow we both will go in a horse cart to see our lands. For many days, the Bhumata present there has been praying me with anguish. Shripada Prabhu, please make me sacred by the touch of your feet. I have a title, Arthatrana Parayana, who comes to console people in distress." Varma said, "My dear Shripada, I have a small submission. We have lands near Pitikapuram. I want to establish a small village there, and through those villagers, I want to till those lands. I will give the lands to the villagers for tilling for a small price. I feel it is good to appoint your father as Karanam to look after the Jamindari affairs. We do not have Ainavilli Karinikam now." Shripada said smilingly, "Tata, you thought about your Jamindari affairs only, but not my Jamindari affairs. It is not acceptable to me. You will tell my father to be Karanam initially. Later, you will say, 'Shripada, you do the Karinikam.' Ghandikota Shripada Srivallabharaju Sharma remains in history as a Karanam of a certain village only. The Karinikam I am going to do is spread throughout the universe. I have my calculations. Every day I see expenditure of crores of Punya Rashis, heaps of merit, gems and corals with them. The purpose of my avatar is to move the Kundalini of universe. Like men, the villages, towns and sacred places also have Kundalini. This is the yoga secret which can be understood only by those who knew Sandra Sindhu Vedam. The Kundalini of Pitikapuram can be moved during the 33rd generations of Bapanarya, Venkatappaya Shreshti and Vatsavayi Narasimha Varma. Where is the hurry now? You make good utilization of this great sacred opportunity you got by luck. My dear Shankar Bhatt, Narasimha Varma tried to keep Shripada in Pitikapuram permanently. Shripada's glory. Ignorance was in high percentage in me. As Shripada said that he himself was Shri Krishna, I questioned jokingly with ignorance. Shripada, you say you are Shri Krishna. Do you have 8 wives and 16,000 gopikas now also? Shripada said with a smile, the 8 types of Prakriti are my 8 wives. Mine is a complete avatar with all 16 kalas. From my body, from my mind, and from this divine Atma called Shripada Srivallabha avatar, powerful vibrations keep emanating every moment in all the 10 directions. Thus, for each Kala, 10 into 10 into 10, 1000 vibrations emanate from body, mind and Atma tattvas every moment. This way, from 16 Kalas, 16,000 vibrations keep emanating. All these are my 16,000 gopikas. In previous avatar, they manifested in human form. In this avatar, they are all formless and vibrant in nature. There is nothing wrong in worshipping my different god forms. It amounts to worshipping me only. You can worship the Shiva form, Vishnu form or Brahma form in me. Similarly, one can worship different god forms in me. The different types of sadhanas, the different states of sadhakas, and many time, action and causes will have effect on the transformation of jivas. Thus he explained. Narasimha's 32 forms gave darshan to Narasimha Raja Varma on that night. They are Kundapada Narasimha Murthy, Kopa Narasimha Murthy, Brahmananda Narasimha Murthy, Samudra Narasimha Murthy, Vishwarupa Narasimha Murthy, Veera Narasimha Murthy, Krura Narasimha Murthy, Bhivatsa Narasimha Murthy, Raudra Narasimha Murthy, Dhumra Narasimha Murthy, Vahni Narasimha Murthy, Vyakra Narasimha Murthy, Bidala Narasimha Murthy, Bhima Narasimha Murthy, Patala Narasimha Murthy, Akasha Narasimha Murthy, Vakra Narasimha Murthy, Chakra Narasimha Murthy, Shankha Narasimha Murthy, Sattva Narasimha Murthy, Adbhuta Narasimha Murthy, Vega Narasimha Murthy, Vidarana Narasimha Murthy, Yogananda Narasimha Murthy, Lakshmi Narasimha Murthy, Bhadra Narasimha Murthy, Raja Narasimha Murthy, Vallabha Narasimha Murthy, He saw Shri Pada Shri Vallabha as the 30th Narasimha Murti and Shri Nrisimha Saraswati Avatar as the 31st Narasimha Murti and Shri Swami Samartha living in Pragnapuram as 32nd Narasimha Murti. The story of Lord Srinivasa. My dear, tomorrow is the most sacred day. Shri Venkateshwara manifested as Archa form in Siddha Yogi in Kanya Rashi, Shravana star, and on Dwadashi Somavaram Monday in the year Vilambi on the 7th day Saptami in the first half of the month of Vaishaka. He took monetary help from Kubera and wrote and gave the promissory note. Shri Padmavati Devi was born in Mrigashira star. Srinivasa manifested in Shravana star. Srinivasa Kalyanam happened in Uttara Phalguni star on the 10th day, Dashami of the first half of the month of Vaishaka. Srinivasa Prabhu also manifested in Bharatvaja Gotra. Akasha Raju was born through Naga Kanyaka to Sudhanva, a descendant of Pandavas. His brother is Tondaman. Vasudhana was the son of Akasha Raju. Srinivasa Prabhu distributed the kingdom to Vasudhana and Tondaman equally on the advice of Agastya Maharshi. Subhaya Shreshti told Shankar Bhat, "Today you take rest. We will sing the divine name of Shri Pada Shri Vallabha the whole night. Tomorrow is the most sacred day according to Jyotishya Shastra. Tomorrow I will explain you the most wonderful leelas of Shri Pada. I will tell you how Chintamani and Bhilva Mangala were brought to Pitikapuram, how Shri Guru showed grace on them, and how the village Chitrada was formed and became famous as the place where Shri Pada showed his leelas in Narasimha Varma's lands. What strange things are going to happen in the coming times and the leelas that will happen before the advent of Shri Pada's last avatar as Kalki. He took me to the nearby Kutiram hut. There were two mats made of Eta tree leaves. Four pure breed dogs were guarding that Kutiram. The effect of remembering Shri Pada. Shri Pada's leelas cannot be repeated by anyone. They are highly appealing to the heart. The heaps of sins gathered in many births will be burned to ashes by merely remembering Shri Pada. Victory to Shri Pada Shri Vallabha. Shri Pada Rajam Sharanam Prapadhye.